Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. This time we're going to present top 7 demon anime characters. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified of our latest videos. Check it out. Number 7 is Rie's Grammary. Rie's Grammary is the main female protagonist of High School DxD. She is the next heiress of the Grammary clan after her older brother, Sir Zix, took the title of Lucifer. She is known as the Crimson Heart Ruin Princess. She is a first-year college student at Kuo Academy, the former president of the Occult Research Club, and the school's number one beauty, as well as one of Kuo Academy's two great ladies alongside Akino Himejima. She is also one of Issei's fiancés. Rie is a beautiful young woman with white skin, blue eyes inherited from her father Zeoticus, and a buxom figure. Her body measurements are B99W58H90cm. Her body weight is 58kg. Her most distinctive feature is her long, beautiful crimson hair, which she also inherited from her father, that reaches down to her thighs with a single hair strand, known in Japan as ahoge, sticking out from the top. Her hair also has loose bangs covering her forehead and side bangs framing her face. Rie's height is 172 cm, making her one of the tallest female characters of the series. Although Rie has worn various types of clothing throughout the series, her most commonly worn outfit is the Kuo Academy girls' school uniform, which consists of a white long-sleeved button-down shirt, short sleeves for spring or summer with a black ribbon on her shirt collar worn under a black shoulder cape and a matching button-down corset. Imagine the skirt with white accents and brown dress shoes over white crew-length socks. Rie also tends to wear seductive lingerie and thongs, especially when she has a desire to sleep with Issei. Rie is a very kind and compassionate optimist, especially to her servants and people close to her. She gets angry and violent whenever people insult her or her bare edge, showing a fiery side to her. This also plays into the fact that she dislikes cruelty towards people, as shown with her disgust over Marius Tebs, who abused his own sister for his own benefit, and how she killed the fallen angels such as Mithalt, Donasig, Kala Warner, and Rainier for their cruel treatment of Issei. She thinks of Issei as a special person and always gets jealous when girls are around him, becoming a totally different person when she sees him and other girls together, or when it comes to training. Despite her macho stature like a woman, Rie tends to act her true edge and become frustrated whenever girls flirt with Issei. Rie has exceptional demonic power even for a high-class devil. Azazel has noted that even without training, she has the potential to become a devil of the highest class relying solely on natural talent alone. Upon utilizing her demonic power of distraction, the surroundings will gradually shake to where her abilities are comparable to an ultimate class devil. Rie is also shown to be proficient in using magic such as the ritual to drain the dragon aura from Issei's left hand to let it appear human again, teleportation magic, healing spells with the most fatal being restored after making skin-to-skin contact, defensive magic to protect herself and her servants from powerful attacks, and create several layers of defensive barriers to protect from the explosive aftershock of Katoria's self-destruct spell. Rie can also use magic communication circles. Number 6 is Okumura Rin. Okumura Rin is the son of Satan and the elder, fraternal twin brother of Yukio Okumura. Studying as an ex-warrior at True Cross Academy, Rin desires to become a Night Master and defeat his biological father. Rin has an extremely compassionate and supportive personality. Rin can be very violent and get in fights, possibly caused by his demon side, but in truth, has a kind heart. He supports his friends and tries to encourage and help them in any way possible. He is also very protective of Yukio and aims to surpass him one day. However, Yukio often finds Rin annoying due to his frequent impulsiveness, stupidity, and his carefree attitude, which makes Yukio look down on Rin as much as he looks up to him, making it hard for Rin to be taken seriously by Yukio and his fellow exorcists, making Rin desperate to earn his brother's approval. He takes offense when Yukio accuses him of killing their father and pointing a gun at him. warning him not to insult him and saying that he isn't going to fight his brother. Rin is also revealed to be very fragile later on when Yukio begins to show signs of insanity and Rin can't find any way to help him. Although he generally hides it, Rin loved his adopted father a great deal and has nothing but good things to say about him. He deeply regrets that the last thing they did was fight, which resulted in Satan taking him over. Much like Yukio, he takes any insult against him very seriously and got really angry when Shiora claimed he died like a coward. He also doesn't like people insulting Yukio, whom he loves and greatly respects. Besides this, however, Rin is surprisingly even-tempered and laid-back and rarely gets angry without a good reason. Rin, as the son of Satan, has inherited his father's trademark flames. Flames of Satan, as suggested, are uniquely blue. The majority of his power are sealed within the demon-slaying blade Kurikara, however, he is able to wield a small amount of blue flames even with his sword sheathed, typically whenever he is enraged. Rin later undergoes training to control his flames to prevent them from leaking out, as well as to ensure that he isn't consumed and refers back to his feral state whenever he drops his sword. He later gained a little control over his flames, however, Rin is still prone to his flames leaking out in a burst of rage. By the time of Izuma's rescue operation, he possesses enough control over his blue flames to create techniques through channeling the flames released through his sword in a coordinate manner. After Kurikara, which contained his demonic heart, broke, his flames released at full power burning him. Then he regressed into his feral demon form and returned to his state of mind. Rin is an aspiring knight master, and as such employs a demonic sword as his main weapon, which in his case with his Kurikara. Rin eventually gains enough skill and control with his flames and sword to be able to perform various techniques with his flames of Satan. Number 5 is Akira Fudo. Akira Fudo is the main protagonist of the Devilman Crybaby anime series. Akira was originally a weak young man with an average build for a teenager. He was rather scrawny and had kept brown hair that had a small tuft near the back. After his transformation into the Devilman, he gained a lean yet sturdy figure with dark circles around his eyes and messy hair. He also grew noticeably taller. Compared to his other counterparts, he has a notable cleft chin. As Devilman, his skin becomes a bluish gray, fur covers his legs and he has clawed feet and fingers. His head is covered in hair that sprouts small wings off the sides and antenna near the top and form a widow's peak with a red forehead. His back also sprouts large black wings with a purple interior. He also has a monkey-like tail. Akira is a very sensitive and caring person. As a child, he would help anyone to the best of his ability, including Ryo Asuka after he had lost his memories, as well as a critically injured cat. Most people knew him as a crybaby who would cry on anyone's behalf, especially if those people bottle up their emotions. Akira's caring attitude, however, leads him to do questionable things like following Miki in secret for her well-being and blindly following the morally questionable Ryo Asuka. Akira becomes more cocky after his initial transformation, openly challenging thugs to a fight and entering a track race with no worries. He tended to act more strongly to his instincts, including intense sexual desires for attractive women, and he even watched porn video in his school's projector room. His caring side, however, remained as he uses his power to help defend the human race from demons. Before his transformation, Akira was not very physically impressive, being the slowest member of the Trike Club. After becoming Devilman, his body was enhanced to a superhuman levels. In his human state, he was able to run at a very high speeds, faster than professional athletes. His strength grew to being able to first lock down Sobin and defeat 5 thugs with only one arm. As Devilman's strength, speed, and reflexes allow him to tear through enemies before they even have the chance to react. His jaw strength alone is able to tear flesh off of bodies. His claws allow him to slice through enemies with ease. The horns on his head could also improve his hearing, allowing him to sense incoming projectiles based on sounds and air pressure. The wings on his back could slow Devilman's fall, allow a high leap into the air, as well as glide and fly long distances. Different men also manifest different abilities depending on situations, including elastic limbs, night vision, and increasing his body temperature to the point of making Gelmer evaporate or even use it outwardly to cause an explosion. Number 4 is Sebastian Michaelis. Sebastian Michaelis is the main character of Black Butler or Kuroshi Tsuji anime series. He is the demon butler of the Phantom Hive household. Sebastian was summoned to shield Phantom Hive when the latter's twin brother was sacrificed in an occult ritual. After convincing Seal to form a contract with him and placing the seal on Seal's right eye, Seal ordered him to slay his abductors. Sebastian decided to adopt a role that is best fit to serve an earl. Therefore, he assumed the form of a butler until Seal completes his personal mission of revenge, that is the substance of their contract. In return, Sebastian will receive Seal's soul. He was then given the name Sebastian by Seal, which used to be his dog's name, for the duration of his duties as Seal's butler. Sebastian takes on the appearance of a tall, handsome adult with black hair, red eyes, and pale skin. He typically dresses in a butler's outfit, which consists of black trousers, a six-button double-breasted tailcoat, and a gray vest. He has the Phantom Hive crest on his shirt, cuffs, and tie. Sebastian also sports white gloves, a pocket watch, and a giant silver label pin bearing the Phantom Hive crest, traditionally worn by the house's head butler. Sebastian notably has black fingernails. The back of his left hand contains the mark of his Faustian contract with Seal Phantom Hive. Details of Sebastian's demonic form include high-heeled stiletto boots, sharp claws, glowing fuchsia irises, slit pupils, and longer, sharper teeth with dark rings and multiple eyes. Sebastian is a dedicated butler to Shield Phantom Hive and upholds a strong sense of duty to his master and household. He faithfully follows and carries out every one of Seal's orders, while ensuring that the Phantom Hive household runs smoothly. He does not sleep, for demons deem it as a form of luxury, and thus he frequently performs tasks for Seal at night. One of his quirks is that he will always respond to Seal's demands with a saying, "Yes, my lord." Sebastian predominantly appears as a courteous and impeccable servant. However, he is in actuality callous, heartless, and sadistic. He is ruthless when attacking others on Seal's orders, and constantly puts Seal in non-fatal danger for his own amusement. Sebastian usually expresses his diabolic nature through his dark, sarcastic humor and inability to see good in anyone. He is known to not take instances in which Seal is in danger seriously, such as kidnappings. However, he displays more concern when it's uncertain that he can save him, such as when Madame Red almost killed Seal or when the Undertaker threatened his life. He is often critical of his master and how he treats his workers, but he has admitted that he does not dislike the butler lifestyle despite all the troubles he goes through on a daily basis. Number 3 is Albedo. Albedo is one of the female characters in Overlord anime series. She is the overseer of the guardians of the Great Tomb of Nazarick. She is in charge of the general management and supervises the activities of the seven floor guardians, meaning that she ranks above the other NPCs in Nazarick. Albedo and her other sisters were created by Tabula Smaragdino. She was originally programmed to be a slut, but Momonga altered her personality and changed her setting to be madly in love with him instead. Albedo is a woman with lustrous jet black hair and the face of a goddess. She has golden irises and vertically split pupils. On her left and right temples are two thick horns protruding crookedly, and on her waist are a pair of black angel wings. Albedo wears a pure white dress with silky gloves covering her slender hands and a golden spiderweb necklace that covers her shoulders and chest. In combat, she wears an impressive black full plate armor with a unique helm and carries the battle axe with her. Extremely loyal and in love, Albedo is infatuated with Ains as programmed by him, often showing obsessive tendencies when it comes to his affairs. She is always vying for Ains' affection, showcasing outbursts of jealousy whenever anyone else appears to be getting close to him. Yet despite this, she states that as the supreme ruler, it would be bizarre for him to only take one wife, implying that she would be content with him taking others as wives as long as she was the only he loves the most. Among all the guardians, she's the most vocal when it comes to expressing her opinions. She will openly denounce any statement or action she deems inappropriate, reaching the point where Anne sometimes considers it as annoyance. As the overseer of the Flower Guardians, she's very level-headed. Alameda can make calm and collected judgments that even Anne sometimes doesn't think of. She takes Anne's orders as a top priority and absolute, punishing anyone, even a Flower Guardian, who would dare to belittle others. According to Ains, he can sense that Alberta has a hatred for humans, whom she calls an inferior species. Alberta boasts the highest defensive power among all the NPCs of Nozarik. Alberta had an impregnable defense when she has her heavy armor fully equipped. Additionally, she is immune to a variety of diseases. She possessed a special skill as a trump card which allows her to transfer the damage she was hit with by taking onto the armor instead. Not only that, but with it, she could even tank a super dire magic spell unscathed without suffering any physical damage whatsoever. If Albedo was to use the skill to divert the damage to her armor, it would ignore this piece of equipment's defense capabilities. In other words, her armor is unexpectedly easy to break apart if used jointly with that skill. Based on that what-if scenario, Albedo's defense and combat potential would fall drastically after the armor is destroyed in combat. She would become an easier target for foes to pick on next after she is no longer protected by her armor. This ability has a limit, however, having only 3 uses per day. Once reached, the outermost part of her armor breaks, and at which point Albedo will show her true form by assimilating what remains to harden her own flesh. Number 2 is Ryuk. Ryuk is one of the characters in Death Note anime series. He is a Shinigami who indirectly gives Light Yagami a Death Note after becoming bored with the Shinigami realm. In an effort to amuse himself, he steals a second Death Note and drops it into the human world for someone to find. This Death Note is discovered by Light, who uses it in an attempt to cleanse the world of evil and injustice, satisfying Ryuk's need for entertainment. Ryuk has a fairly humanoid appearance. He's extremely slim and has light gray skin, almost bluish in color, with spiky black hair, thin blue-gray lips, and sharp pointed teeth. His limbs are abnormally long, and he wears rings on his fingers. He has large, round yellow eyes with bright red irises and retractable feather-like wings on his back that enable him to fly. Ryuk is different from most Shinigami in that he does not want to simply pass time away in the Shinigami realm but find something to relieve his boredom, and he's unaffected by the mocking he receives from other Shinigami for it. Ryuk regards Light as interesting, specifically due to his experiments and the loopholes he discovers regarding the Death Note's rule and instructions, occasionally discovering abilities of the notebook even Ryuk did not know existed. Though he finds Light interesting, he does not care whether Light lives or dies and does not actively assist him. At times, he withholds important information from Light and only assists him when he has something to gain from it. As his only purpose in dropping the notebook was because he was bored, most of his actions are primarily motivated by wanting to see something interesting, as he sees Light's use of the Death Note and the way humans react to it as truly entertaining. Ryuk is intelligent, but Light's ability to understand his desires easily makes him able to be manipulated. Ryuk has a great fondness for apples, stating the addiction to be an equivalent of cigarettes and alcohol for humans. Shinigami apples are withered and taste like sand, as he shows Misa at one point, which is why he prefers apples from the human world. He suffers certain symptoms of withdrawal if he goes too long without eating them, involving twisting himself up like a pretzel and doing handstands. He also states that he's shy around girls, revealed when Misa regains her memories and hugs Ryuk in excitement. Number 1 is Mao Sadao. Mao Sadao, or Satan Jacob, is the main protagonist of the Hatareku Mao-sama anime series. He was once the demon king who declared war and anti-Isla in attempt to annex the 4 continents. However, due to the actions of the hero Amelia Justina and her companions, he was forced to retreat to Earth, causing him to lose almost all of his powers. King Satan is a humanoid demon that stands over 2 meters tall, possessing a fair complexion, sharp red eyes, and slightly messy black hair with a mildly unkempt, spiky appearance. His body is well built, with a muscular torso, thick neck, and toned arms and legs. Though his default form is humanoid in appearance, he possesses several features that are decidedly more demonic, including sharp clawed hands, a pair of yellow-ridged horns that curve outwards from beneath his hair along the sides of his head, and large furry goat-like legs ending in thick hooves. Satan also possesses 2 large bat-like wings that span several times the length of his body when unfurled, though he does not require them to fly and usually keeps them hidden inside his body. His outfit as the ruler of demons consists of a dark jacket with a gold trim around the seams, the bottom partially opened to reveal his vest. He wears short black pants which are the same color as his top, the former of which are tucked into a pair of large dark boots that cover his animal-like calves and feet. Over his clothing, he wears a high-colored cape in the same colors as his jacket, fastened at the front with a thin golden chain and held in place by large shoulder pads bearing a small resemblance to his horns. As a human, Mao has the appearance of an average Japanese young man. His facial features and hair are largely unchanged from his original demonic form, though he appears younger and his face more expressive than before. The most noticeable difference, aside from losing his horns, hoofed legs, wings, and claws, is the drastic reduction in stature between his human and demon forms. As Sadao Mao, the Demon King is roughly the height of the average human, being noticeably shorter than before with a smaller build that lacks the musculature and imposing size of his previous body. While living in Japan, he normally wears simple clothing purchased from Uniqlo, a store specializing in low-budget, used clothing, his typical garb being a simple t-shirt and jeans. While working at McDonald's, Mao dresses in the franchise's uniform consisting of a short-sleeved red t-shirt with a button-up collar, a yellow strip running across the mid-torso with the company's logo on the right breast. Also included is a pair of black pants, a belt, and a matching visor hat, also bearing the McDonald's logo. Perhaps the most intelligent and charismatic of his kind, the Demon King came from humble origins as a member of a low-class goblin tribe, yet through tireless efforts and a drive to better his people, managed to gain support from others, eventually uniting the warring factions of the demon world under his rule. Satan was well-known throughout the lands as the great overlord of his people, his name synonymous with the terror and cruelty his army brought to those unfortunate enough to fall victim. On Earth, Sadao Mao is shown to be a diligent and proactive employee, instead applying his strong drive and determination to better himself in his new life. Forced to spend time living as a human and interacting with those he previously considered to be lesser beings, the Demon King slowly began to understand mankind, and has since developed a kind-hearted and cheerful disposition, making him popular among both his colleagues and neighbors. While he does not desire to cause trouble to the world that has treated him with nothing but kindness, Satan has not entirely lost his desire for power and influence, and instead strives to climb the corporate ladder at McDonald's. As the Demon Lord, Satan possessed great demonic power. Demonic magic is extremely strong, and each user seems to have a unique colored aura to indicate its presence. For him, that color is black or red. On Earth, he lost most of his powers and was weakened to the point that he could only function as an average human. Finding magical sources was near impossible as magic is largely only present in the form of fiction. However, his powers can be temporarily restored by feeding off negative emotions like fear and despair from sentient beings in his surroundings. His power including transformation, hypnosis, teleportation, regeneration, and many more. Well, it's all about top 7 demon anime characters that we can present this time. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, see you next time!